energy and how the mobility of people are going to be. And I think Pickens has got some good ideas, and we're just here to learn and see what goes on. It's a wonderful event that's being put on.
This very land we're sitting on was covered with oil tanks and pollution, and Goodwin College is proud of our new campus that has helped rejuvenate the riverfront property in this area.
Well, Mark, thank you for that introduction, but I have to say that prior to coming to Goodwin College today on the scenic banks of the Connecticut River, we went over to the garden spot of the Northeast. We wanted to make sure that when we had T. Boone Pickens here, he got a real flavor for East Hartford, Connecticut, so we took him to Augie and Ray's. You know, people, they'll give you their unvarnished opinion about most everything. But primarily, you know, it's they like to talk about sports and politics, so when T. Boone came in, they had the Oklahoma State fight song on, Jeff. You can imagine that, you know? So, and they also had special shirts that were made in black and orange, the colors of Oklahoma State as well. And I told T. Boone, you know, I have a, he had a lot of buildings named after him, and bought stadiums. I said, I have a breakfast sandwich named after me. And some of you may know that I had a little surgery this summer. And my brother Dan went in and told Ernie, he said, hey, geez, my brother's having surgery here. He goes, oh, no. Looks up at the sign. He says, you better put next to that sandwich, consult your doctor first. So I was rather offended. I came back and said to Ernie, look, you know, I got to tell you, clean bill of health. I said, not an artery, not a vein that isn't clear. Ernie says, is that right? He says, good. Put back up there, healthy choice. So we're glad to be here, and what an honor. Jeff Hathaway is here, and you'd be glad to know that John Toner was there at Augie and Ray's, as many of you know, a former athletic director at the University of Connecticut, who actually made the trek out to Notre Dame with the team. And how great is that, by the way? Such a tremendous thing for our program. Although I was here with Timmy Moynihan, and we had to console Freddie Clark, who said he's been rooting for the Irish since 1948. He said, get over it, Freddie. It's the University of Connecticut. What a great win it was for our program, and for Randy Edsel, and for the entire team, given the kind of season that they've had. We're all so proud of them, and the reflection that that has on the University of Connecticut. I've had the opportunity to work with T. Boone Pickens for the last several years. He's spoken before our caucus, and as he says, he's out of politics. But I'll tell you, he has a genuine desire and an American authenticity that you rarely find. He's committed to making sure that America is energy independent. He came before our caucus and laid out the facts. He said, heck, I'm for drilling. He said, I'm an oil man. And he said, but you got to face the facts. Facts are we have 4% of the world's population. We consume 25% of the world's energy. And we only have 2% of those reserves. And he's advocating and pushing for wind and solar and geothermal and any kind of technology that will wean off a dependency on foreign oil. What caught my attention, I was telling Timmy Moynihan this, is that he said, you know, he said, I don't like it. I haven't been a dealer all my life. When I see those OPEC countries in a room, together, huddled, we're on the outside of that room. That's not an enviable position. We simply have got to stop exporting American dollars abroad. We have to invest American dollars here at home. T. Boone Pickens has a plan. We've got legislation, and we're going to make that happen. This is a forum. It's not, we don't want to make Boone can speak anywhere, I think he speaks best when we have a conversation. I think as you hear from him, you'll see just how knowledgeable and conversational he can be. With the emphasis on his knowledge and his vision and where we have to take this country and the kind of leadership that he's providing, not only in terms of the Army and the grassroots movement that he's formed all across the country, also putting his money where his vision is in terms of making sure that this message gets out. He's a unique American. It's an honor to have him here at Goodwin College and in East Hartford, Connecticut. Ladies and gentlemen,
our reserves are going down. Our production going down. We peaked in 1970, and it's been, we've come down from there. We're producing now 5 million barrels of oil and 2 million barrels of natural gas liquids. That's the same thing as oil, but 7 million barrels. We're using, as John said, 21 million barrels a day, and so we're producing one-third of that. So we're importing about two-thirds of all the oil we use. The huge transfer of dollars out of this country. It's the largest transfer of wealth in the history of mankind. And the sad part about it is that over half of that two-thirds that we are importing goes to what I consider to be countries that are not friendly to us, even to the point that they're enemies about. Venezuela, for instance, we buy 1,200,000 barrels of oil a day from Venezuela. What a cluck that guy is down there. And what he says about us, he hates us. And that oil will go, within 3 years, will go to China just as soon as they have a refinery that can process 12-gravity crude and high sulfur. So that will go away from us. So that isn't the only reason I want to do something, but that's just an example of where we're getting our oil. And we're not smart to do it. I think the credibility of America has suffered. We all, I think, to some degree, have said, you know, gosh, our credibility, we're Americans are good people. We're kind, we're considerate. We help on any disaster in the world. We go immediately to it and help for light duty. I can be natural gas for heavy duty. I said, fine, so I want to tell you all, I'm with Al Gore, light duty battery. Okay, will it work? Of course it'll work. And it will work on light duty. It's more expensive. You get into all these kind of things pretty quick. It's just, what do these things cost? Natural gas is cheaper by the gallon, a dollar. I mean, it's a huge advantage for us. A good comparison is to take what is 1 MCF of natural gas. It's equivalent to 9 gallons of diesel. Okay, that's a comparison. 9 gallons of diesel is $21. 1 MCF of natural gas is $4. Huge in our favor. The way to look at it, again, is natural gas is easily $1 a gallon cheaper than diesel. So it's, you know, the reason the 4 to 21, you've got to do some transportation and compression and all in there, but it still leaves you with $1 a gallon cheaper. So is that my story? Not quite. Give me 3 more minutes and I've got it.